Hey guys, welcome back to a brand new video. Video 400, you guys, we did it, 400 unboxings on my channel. And of course we have to do it for the Amazon exclusive of Han Solo in the Millennium Falcon. Super duper dope. You guys, I'm so excited for this pop. When I first thought, I was like, this is a bit much, but honestly, like, yeah, it is really, really cool. There's actually a really cool story to this. So this pop, I think, retails for about 80 bucks. I got it for $40. There was a little bit of a price negotiation thing going on. That was totally worth it, absolutely. Very, very cool. I really, really like this pop. Again, I'm a big fan of the pop rides. And I mean, this one, like, it's not considered one, but it should be. I mean, this thing is huge, you guys. This is so, so, so big. I mean, just take a look. There's Han Solo right there, looking fresh. Can't wait to open this thing up for you guys. Let's take a look at the back. It's just Han, obviously, on this thing. There's nothing else going on in the back. But yeah, this is a really, really cool pop, you guys. So we're going to have to unbox this together, right? Are you guys ready? Video 400 starts right now. Here we go. Han Solo and the Millennium Falcon. All right, guys. Here he is to the front. This is Han Solo in the Millennium Falcon. So, so cool, you guys. Like, I'm really, really so excited this is unboxing 400, honestly. I'm always worried when I get to, like, the numbers, like, the 100, 200, 300. I'm always, like, really, really nervous. Like, is the pop gonna be cool? Like, I mean, all, like, I love all my Funko Pops, no question. But sometimes you just wanna, like, kind of end off doing, like, a whole 100 pops with a bang, or start off one with a bang. And I think $3.99 was really, really cool with the Vader in the meditation chamber. But this one is really, really cool for number 400 as well. So I hope it sets the tone for, like, a really cool 100 coming up. A lot of great Funkos have been announced from Funko already this year that I'm really excited for. How those are going to play out, I don't know. I am really excited for all the Haunted Mansion ones coming out. I did pre-order pretty much all of them except for one. I think that's the one where he's playing the organ, only because that is going to be a Disney Parks exclusive. I don't know if there's a link to that, to order that online yet. I have no idea. I've been checking up little by little. I really was not impressed with the San Diego Comic-Con pops this year, so I don't plan on getting too many of them. I might get, like, the cat version of Yzma, possibly, but many of the other ones I just really wasn't that into, to be honest. So, but there have been a few cool ones. There were a few pops earlier this year that I really did like that I wasn't able to get my hands on, some that I was, and I'll be unboxing those pretty soon. Very cool. This is great. I really like this pop. I will say, I am, over the next couple of months, I'm gonna get into more unveilings than unboxings. Unboxings will be taking a little bit of a backseat, but my unveilings will be taking center stage. So if you guys do like Funkos that are already unboxed, you guys will see those. Basically, my unveilings will be featuring pops that I've already, like, unboxed, not on my channel, but just don't have their boxes anymore, be they in storage or whatever the case, and I'll be unveiling those to you guys. So I'll still be doing that. I'm gonna be doing Marvel Legends figures as well, and other figures that I have in my collection. So we'll be getting into a lot of different things, and then we'll, of course, we'll still be doing unboxings. That will not change, but they'll probably be a little bit less for a little while. Here we have the Millennium Falcon to the side. You can see, like, the shooter from the bottom. Super duper cool. I mean, just look at the undercarriage of this thing, man. I really want to show you guys pretty much everything, because this is, I mean, not just pretty much, I want to show you guys everything, even like the bottom, dude. Like, this is a really well thought out, well designed pop. I think when I first saw this pop, I was like, nah, I'm not getting this, dude. This is too much. This is a little bit much. But then when I thought about it, I was like, why don't I actually want this? Why don't I have this in my collection? My dad and I are huge, huge Star Wars fans, especially my dad. Like, I grew up loving Star Wars because of him. I was like, okay, Dad, I'm a fan. Teach me your ways, sir. And he did. He was like, okay, this is what you need to watch. And so one Christmas, he ended up getting me, like, all of them, all the movies. And I just, like, sat there and I just watched them over and over and over again. And I finally understood. It took episode one, me liking episode one, for me to understand why the series is so cool to me. Here it is to the back. Now, I know we've had this discussion before, so if you're new to this channel, settle in for a story. If you're not new to this and you've already heard why I like episode one, but yeah, episode one just hit me, like I said, I think, where I live. You know, it's not that I couldn't relate to Luke, but as a kid, like, when I was like 7, 8 watching these films, I really couldn't. But Anakin, you know, he was 9 when I was 9, so it fit really well. I was able to really understand his point of view in all this. And there were so many other characters that were interesting. Darth Maul, for one. Queen Amidala. Like, I love the face paint, the costumes that they got to wear. There were a lot of really cool fight scenes. So there were a lot of really cool things about Star Wars Episode One that really kept my interest. Getting to see the original trilogy after that, there were pieces that I just had to figure out, like what made him become Darth Vader. There were so many things that I was like, I need to know this. And so the prequel series, while they're not my favorite films, I definitely do appreciate them. And I actually do have a special love for at least Phantom Menace and Revenge of the Sith. I do really, I like Attack of the Clones as far as Padme. Padme is really what made me love that movie, because I just love her character and all the costumes she gets to wear. She's really great and she needs more pops. Here the Millennium Falcon is to the other side. But getting back to that, yeah, so she really doesn't get enough love. To be honest, most of the prequel characters don't get enough love when it comes to making new Funkos. I think Darth Maul is one of the ones that's gotten a lot of pops. Young Anakin has too, but I think like Hayden Christensen Anakin has not gotten the love I think he deserves as far as Funko Pops go. I'm not talking about his acting as Anakin. I'm just talking about the Funko Pops. I think he needs a few more Funko Pops, and definitely Padme. I think Queen Amidala should have a Funko Pop for every last one of her outfits. I know I would buy them. I know a ton of people who would buy them, guys and girls alike. In fact, when Star Wars, when Galaxy's Edge first opened in Disneyland, I went to the Galaxy's Edge preview, and I actually wore a Queen Amidala get up, and not like a complete get up, just kind of homage to her. I made some mini ears, turned them into something like more Queen Amidala-esque. I put on like a little bit of a veil, and people were just like, oh my gosh, like that's what's missing in Galaxy's Edge. There's no Amidala love. And so now there's a few different things that are in there, but the opening day, a lot of cast members were really like happy to see me there. They took pictures with me because they're like, this is so cool. Someone actually thought of Amidala, because I knew there would be no representation of her in there. And there's a little bit now, but nowhere near as much. Honestly, she could have her own, her and Leia could have their own fashion store in Galaxy's Edge. Like, how cool would that be? But I think she should definitely get more love than she does. Very cool. This is really cool. I love the way this looks, you guys. Right. Before we end this video, I actually do have a lightsaber light that I'm using. You can kind of see the blue hues in it. So I'm going to go ahead and take this off really quick and show you guys what it would look like without. Check that out. Check that out, you guys. So cool. Yeah, I really like that. Wow. That's so cool, you guys. That is absolutely neat. Really, really awesome. So guys, I want to say thank you so much for all of your likes, your follow, subscribes. Thank you for sharing. If you are not subscribed to the channel yet, make sure to hit that subscribe button. Leave me a nice big like on this video. It lets me know you guys like the content that I'm putting out. And please feel free to leave me a comment. I love hearing from all of you guys. I appreciate you guys so much for all that you guys do. I really could not do any of this without you. 400 unboxings, you guys. 400 unboxings. I still can't believe it. It's blowing my mind. I hope you guys really enjoyed this video, and I hope you guys come back for more. By the way, if you are new to this channel, hi, what's up? It's so nice to have you guys here. I do unboxings, I do unveilings, and I love to talk about nerdy things. I'm getting into doing a little other kinds of videos too, as in like Funko Pops that people want to see, Funko Pops I know I want to see from different lines. But guys, I want to say thank you so much for everything you guys have done, and I will see you guys in the next video. Until then, guys, have a great day. May the Force be with you. Peace.